Do you have tight hips? If you're a runner, you most likely have tight hips. Why? Because you're a human, and most humans have really tight hips. My name is Dr. Jordan Fairley, and in this video, I'm gonna give you a simple routine you can do before every single run to really open up your hips and improve your running stride. By having really tight hips, you're gonna be way more prone to running-related injuries such as hip pain, low back pain, and any pain in the lower extremities because it's altering how you're moving as you are running throughout your gait cycle. So, as humans, the majority of us are sitting in chairs for long periods of time. Whether you work at a desk or you commute long hours, or maybe you have a 10-minute commute just to your running trail, what happens is your hip flexor, which I'll illustrate with this yellow caution tape. Your hip flexor goes all the way from your leg, has continuous fibers that come up past the belly and into your diaphragm. At full length, this hip flexor should be able to extend. The problem is most of us are sitting for long periods of time, and since the body likes tension, this hip flexor gets shortened over time. However, then we're expected to get out of our car and onto the trail where we stand up fully and extend, and our hip flexor needs to lengthen. The problem is our body's gotten used to this short, tight pattern. So I'm gonna show you a simple routine you can do to open those up and improve your gait. So first and foremost, I wanna help you understand your hip flexor, the psoas, the main portion of the hip that we're going to open up, attaches to your diaphragm and your spine. So we're gonna use deep diaphragmatic breaths. So breathing into our belly, creating length, and as you exhale, maintain that length. And as you do that, you're pulling upward on that hip flexor, so you're creating bigger stretch, and you're also opening up your hips as we go through this gentle routine. So first and foremost, we're gonna get some extension and flexion of the hip. You can hold on to something if you need the balance. So we're gonna take a huge breath in. Stabilize your low back and your abdomen as you then go into some extension and flexion. So these are some simple leg swings, trying to maximize how far backward you're bringing your leg and how far upward you're bringing your leg without letting your low back start to fold forwards. So I'm keeping that core stability as I do this. And now I can go into more of a hurdle type of range of motion, which is internal external rotation of that hip. So again, stabilizing, bring leg up and through. This is getting external rotation of that hip and then bringing it into internal rotation. You can then switch sides, so just going all the way out, opening up that hip into external rotation. Again, the hip is actually a ball type of socket joint, and so we're just going through all these different plane lines. If you don't need the balance, you can test out not holding onto something and just alternate with your arms as you swing through, because as we're running, we're doing alternating leg and arm movement. So flexion, extension, trying to maximize the range of motion, and then we're going into the rotation component. So all the way out, bringing that leg through, external, internal rotation of the hip, then alternating the other way, trying to maximize how far you're bringing that leg out as you're going through while keeping your core nice and tight. So we're getting some movements. Now we're gonna get into more of an opening stretch. And as we do this, we're gonna go through what are called star lunges. So these are gonna be lunges, and most of you are just aware of lunging forward here. We wanna go all the way through different ranges of motion of that hip. So we're gonna be going into a 45-degree angle, lateral, another 45-degree angle, straight ahead, and we're gonna make our way all the way around this routine. So I'm gonna start with my left foot forward, back foot back, pointed in towards that front foot, taking that huge breath in. I'm up on my back toe, holding that space. Breathing in, holding that, pulling that heel back down to the ground. And now I'm gonna go into a lunge. So pulling my pubic bone up towards my chest and then dropping my knee down to the ground, feeling that stretch in from my hip flexor into the quad. I could hold here, breathe, bring that arm up, lean to get even more of the side part of the hip, coming back up, push through that heel, stand back up. Now we're going into that first 45, which is a deep squat. So my legs come out, feet are at 90, squatting down in this position, keeping my spine nice and straight. My knees drive out, heels are still on the ground, tucking my chest back, shoulders back, and I can put some more weight into each side, maximizing the range of motion of this hip, push through the heels, come back up, going lateral. Leg comes out, spine stays straight, big breath in, going over into that outer leg, big breath. As you exhale, go into that a little bit deeper, come back up, 45 degree angle in front here, leg turns in, dropping down to get a different angle of that hip capsule now, big breath. Exhale, stretch, come back up. Now I'm gonna be going forwards, but so you can see, I'm gonna turn my body. We're going into a forward lunge and then down to the ground into the world's greatest stretch. If you haven't done this before, you'll find out why it's called that. In this position, extending that back leg back, pushing my heel down to the ground, big breath into my belly, trying to drive my low back and hips into the ground, and I can turn this all the way up. Opening up the outer glute fibers on that leg, big breath. As you exhale, stretch and push that heel back down the ground. And then we're going to the other side. So here, pushing through that heel, coming up the other leg, big breath in. As you exhale, stretch even more. Coming back down, both hands on either side, push through that front heel. Whoo, coming back up, that leg feels good. Now we're alternating legs, going into that lunge again. So the other foot forwards, back leg internally rotated towards that front foot, up on my heel, big breath in, stretch. Drop that heel down to the ground, feeling that hip flexor on the front side, open up. Feel a couple reps here, big breath, trying to reach for the spine, hold the heel here, drop that heel down to the ground, awesome. In this position, pubic bone comes up, dropping that knee down to the ground. Oh my gosh, I feel that into my quad and my hip flexor and my low back, breathing, creating space. Open up that other side, push through that front heel, coming back up, up the other way around that circle, 45 degree angle, squat down, spine stays straight, knees are out, chest up. I can get some shoulder range of motion here. Big breath in, pushing into that leg, pushing in the other leg, drive through the heels, come up, going out to the lateral lunge in this position. Hips come back, arms come out to counterbalance. Big breath, both feet are flat on the ground. Drive through that heel, come back up, 45 degree angle. Here, rotate in, drop down. That feels so good. Breath in, pubic bone forward, out, push through. Last one, now we're going, this would be fours, but so you can see, dropping into that world's greatest stretch. Here, big breath in, drive that heel back, down to the ground, opening up,
push that heel down, hips coming down to the ground, keep your spine
straight, switching arms, reset the spine. I shouldn't see any rounding. Spine stays nice and straight, breath in, rotate up that other way, push that heel down to the ground, come back down, push through that front foot, and I'm up and I feel absolutely amazing. Through all those ranges of motion, not only did I open up the hip flexors, I got every single plane line of that ball and socket joint, and I stabilized the external rotators and all of the muscles that surround my pelvis and my hip as well. So not only am I now more loose and mobile in the hips, I'm also more stable and strong. Please, please, please try this before you run and make it a habit for your routine before every single run. And you'll start to notice that not only are you able to be more mobile and have an increased stride length, but you're also going to decrease your injury rates as you're running, so you can run happier, healthier, longer, and stronger. My name is Dr. Jordan Fairley. If you have appreciated the content in this video, like it, subscribe, ask me any questions around running. I'm here to help you, and I look forward to seeing you on the trails. wait. Before you go, I wanna say thank you again for watching this video. And I also want to invite you to the Vital Stride Community Facebook group, where runners like you are asking running related questions, and I'm helping people overcome repetitive running injuries. I look forward to seeing you in the group.